An introduction to the Urkund analysis. Learn the basics of our redesigned analysis report. Follow this guide that takes you through the new interface and the functions of our Urkund analysis step by step. We will start off with an overview of the interface. Firstly, we'll go into detail of the document overview bar. This is where you'll get a quick overview of all findings in the document. By clicking on a specific finding, you'll see details about the specific match or warning. You also have the option to investigate it further in the findings view. Next up, we'll take a closer look at findings in the overview bar. In our analysis, we distinguish between matching text or warnings. Click on a finding in the document overview bar and you will see a snippet of the matching text or explanation of the warning. Head straight to view details of the finding, or continue to go through all matches to get a quick overview. Next is the findings function. This field tells you how many findings there are in the document. Click on the findings view to take a closer look at detected findings and compare them side by side with the matching text. In our analysis, we distinguish between matching text and warnings, which can be reached separately. If you prefer to go directly to the entire document and have all findings highlighted, click on the big button showing now. After findings, let's take a closer look at the similarity bars. It represents the aggregated text similarity of the document. In here, we show two similarities: this assignment's aggregated similarity percentage and the receiver's average similarity, i.e., the average similarity of all submitted documents to this receiver, the receiver usually being the teacher. Urkbot. Urkbot is here to help you out. It will provide you with the document-specific tips that can help you interpret the analysis report. This feature is still under development and will be improved further. Submission details. Here, you'll find all necessary information about the document. Submitter name, file name, time and date of the submission, submission ID and message. If you want to export the analysis as a PDF and download it to your computer, click on the arrow button. The question mark will open this quick start guide in a new tab. The findings tab has several functions that we will now go into detail on. How to understand the findings tab. The findings tab is the main way to assess the Urkund analysis. Here, you'll see the student's text side by side with the match source text. That allows you to fully focus on going through the matches without having to scroll through the whole document, which, of course, you can do through the entire document tab. Type of findings. Under this function, you can navigate between the different finding types, matching text and warnings. Under the Show in Text feature, you'll find the option to, for example, highlight quotes, brackets, or get detailed text differences. These settings can be changed to fit your workflow in the settings menu. Under detailed text differences, you basically see the exact differences between the submitting text and the matching text, which are highlighted in the matching text. Words highlighted with yellow mean that they have been substituted, and red that they have been removed. In the side-by-side box, you can have the submitted text on the left and the found matches on the right and compare them directly. The percentage you see shows the text similarity for the specific block of text that you are looking at. The source shows you a link to the original source. The symbol tells you which type of source it is: W meaning website, SA student assignment, and J which is content from a journal. Sometimes, the source cannot be shown for various reasons, such as a specific agreement with our partners, or if the author has chosen to exempt the content. In the header, you switch between findings, sources, and entire document via the tabs. You'll also find some quick info about the document, how to export the PDF, and the help function. In the profile menu, you can sign in, see your settings, and overall options for example, changing your language. Next up is our Source tab. Here you find a list of all original sources that were found during the analysis, such as sources that we match the document's content with. We are currently working on improving this view, but this will give you an idea of how it may look. You will be able to see a list of several identified sources in a separate view. Click on a single source to get more info. Under the source legend, you'll find what icon refers to which type of source. W stands for website, SA, student assignments, which are documents previously submitted to Urkund and stored in our archives, and J, journal. The source matches number shows you how many times the system found a match against a specific source. How to exclude a source? You can choose to omit a source from the analysis if you wish. Simply click on the toggle button and the source will be excluded from the analysis. Next up is the entire document tab. The submitted document is shown in its entirety here. All findings are highlighted in the text, allowing you to do a side-by-side comparison if you wish. The matching text and warnings are highlighted both by colour in the text and by corresponding icons to the right. Click on the findings icon to access the matching source text or the warning explanation of the document. Click on the matching text icon to see the matching source text on the right of the submitted text. This way, you can do a side-by-side comparison, which can come in handy. Toggle on the detailed text differences to make sure you don't miss anything important. If you prefer to see the match in the findings tab, click on View Details. Congratulations! You can now get started with our Urkund analysis.